This week on What in the World is Going On, Jordan demands Israel stop work at the Western Wall. Stay tuned, friends. Arut Shiva reported earlier this month a Jordanian foreign minister saying, quote, only WAIF has authority to renovate, maintain Al-Aqsa Mosque, including the Western Wall. They go on to say that the foreign ministry spokesman claimed that the Jordanian WAIF has exclusive authority over the Western Wall under international law. What's this all about? Well, in short, Israel, in addition to maintaining the Western Wall Plaza, wants to renovate and create additional space along the Western Wall for anyone in a non-Orthodox way to be able to go and pray and hold services there. And of course, this plan is met with much opposition, especially from that of the Jordanians. And it's a sad thing, friends, that even though Israel has sovereignty as a result of the Six-Day War over the entire Temple Mount and its retaining walls, she cannot rule over it. And in part, it's because of Israel's defense minister Moshe Dayan's decision and direction in 1967 to really appease the Arab world, and he allowed the Jordanian WAIF to retain this control. But more than that, friends, it is because God said that that would happen. And I'm reminded of Jesus' words in Luke 21:24, where Jesus said that Jerusalem would be trodden down by the Gentiles until the times of the Gentiles be fulfilled. And that's exactly what we see happening in our world today. And it's amazing that Jordan and the Palestinians continue to flex their muscles, demanding Israel cease from really doing anything at all at the Western Wall, as well as on the Temple Mount. They don't want them there at all, period. And that's amazing, especially after they received 77% of the Jewish people's land that was to be allotted to them, according to the Balfour Declaration in San Remo, Italy, in 1920. But that's not enough for the Palestinians and the Jordanians, as we know. And as a result, we continue to see them and really most of the world continuing to act and to try to rule over Israel and her affairs. And, you know, none of that surprises me, because this is where God has placed his name forever. And we can read that in 2 Chronicles chapter 6, verses 5 and 6. This is where Abraham offered Isaac, and where the first and second temples once stood. This is where Jesus was crucified, and where one day he will rule over the nations from there for 1,000 years. And Satan knows that, and Satan hates that. And thus, this has become one of the most explosive pieces of property in the world. And here's a warning to the world, as they think they can treat God's people and his land any way they want because the God of Israel doesn't exist. And this is 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 16, in regards to Solomon's temple that stood at one time on the Temple Mount. God says, for now I have chosen and sanctified this house that my name may be there forever, and mine eyes and my heart shall be there perpetually. Wow. So until next week, friends, this has been What in the World is Going On with the Friends of Israel. God's Prayer.